In this tutorial, you're going to learn how to make this. Firstly, go download the start hip file in the description below to follow along. Let's explain what is going on here. This node here includes the frame structure. It is fully procedural, and this null on the right extracts the polygons that will be used as cloth in Vellum. Let's go over to the Vellum geo node and see what is already set up. Basically, I am bringing in the cloth primitives from the frame geo network with object merge and remeshing it. Then using polywire as a bounding region to create a point group of the outer points named cloth underscore pin. The UV randomize is a bonus. It is to fix the issue of visible repeating textures when you stack geometries on top of each other. Okay, let's begin by placing down an edge fracture node to allow our cloth to tear. In the node, I'm going to set the initial pieces to 100. Usually, more pieces will look nicer, but will slow down the simulation. The last step in this node is to disable original point group, as we won't be using it, and rename new point group to weld underscore PTS. Here is a guide on how to set stiffness parameters in Vellum. This is not a beginner's tutorial, so I expect you to already have a basic understanding of Vellum. Now that is out of the way, begin with a Vellum configure cloth. Go to the pin points field and select the cloth underscore pin group and leave it permanent. The stretch and bend stiffness values depends on what you want. I'm going for a rubber-like cloth. And you can copy my values here. Next is to place down Vellum weld points. Set the group type to points and choose weld underscore PTS. For the bend stiffness, I'm going to lower it slightly. And at the bottom, enable breaking, and I chose a threshold of 0.1 for my setup. This value again depends on what you want, but basically it sets how easy it is to break the welds. The last steps are to create two nulls for importing the geometry and the constraints later in the DOP Net. Let's move on to the grain setup. Place down a sphere, uniform scale to 0.15, and move up 4 units in Y. Now, put down Vellum configure grain, enable create points from volume, and also enable jitter. Once again, you can copy my values. Obviously, keep in mind that the mass value is important because it will affect how the cloth will tear. Next, create a point group. We will use this later to apply pop forces. Once again, create two nulls for the .NET import. We are now entering the nitty-gritty part of the tutorial. Begin with an empty DOP net. Set the substeps to 2 and dive inside. Start with a gravity, a Vellum solver, substeps to 2 and constraint iterations to 50. Next, a Vellum object. Then create a merge. And bring in the cloth and grains using Vellum source. In here, we will use the nulls we created before. For the sub path, select out cloth geo, and for the constraint sub path, select out cloth const. Repeat this step for the grains. Now for the collisions. Place down a static object. In the sub path, select the out frame. Scroll down and go to the Collisions tab. Select Use Volume Collisions. And in the Bullet Data tab, select Representation to Concave and Collision Padding to 0. Lastly, create a ground plane. And connect these up using a merge and make sure to connect it in the right order. This is all we need for the basic setup. But we want to use pop forces to add additional complexity. First is a pop drag. I'm going to set the air resistance to 1.5. Second is a pop force. Enable group and select the grains group that we made earlier. I'm going to activate it for only 4 frames and set the amplitude to 6 and swirl size to 0.5. Why I'm using this pop force is to just agitate the position of the grains. The last pop force is a pop attract. Again, enable group, select the grains group, and set the force scale to 1.5. This pop attract is not necessary, but it will help guide the grains and when it gets to the bottom, clump together nicely. Okay, let's try simulating now. You might be thinking, this is nothing like what you promised. Well, that's because we haven't done a very important step. Let's go back up to the Vellum weld constraints. Next to the breaking threshold, select scale by attribute and copy this name below. Then place down an attribute noise node just above the Vellum cloth constraints. What this node will allow us to do is to control which areas will tear by mapping a noise. In this node, paste the name and change the type to float, and click this icon to visualize the noise. First of all, increase the amplitude to 1.5, set the element size to 0.6, offset it by 7.5, lattice warp to 1, and remap the values to 0.1 to 1. Essentially, what you see here is that the blue regions have a lower threshold, thus tearing easily, and the red values has a higher threshold, meaning they will stay intact. Okay, we're done in this node, so turn off the color visualization, go back to the DOP Net, and simulate it again. You'll notice that if you play the simulation cache in real time, it is quite fast, so I'm going to stretch it out with a retime node. In order to do that, we must bring in the geometry with a DOP import. Drag the DOP Net in and the object mask as Vellum Object 1, and we want to bring in geometry. Next, type Time Warp, put it below, and turn on Interpolate Frames and Scale Velocities. Change the mode to By Speed. We'll bring in 15 to 120 of our simulation frames for the input and output it to 1 to 168 and set the speed to 0.45. Now if you play the simulation, you can see that it is playing at a much more reasonable speed. But remember, this is just a trick and is not simulating more frames in between, but just simply interpolating between the point positions. At this point, you still won't be able to render this, so we must do some extra steps. With two blast nodes, I'm going to separate the grains and the cloth. Use the grains group and enable delete non-selected, make a null and name it accordingly. Duplicate the blast node, disable delete non-selected, create a null and name it again. For the cloth geometry, use a Vellum post-process to subdivide the mesh and create some thickness, and finish with a normal node. For the grains, dive outside and create a new geo node. Inside the node, bring in the grains with an object merge. One important thing to note here is that the grains you see here does not have any geometry. It's just a sprite image. So to render this, you have two options. One is to use copy to points and a sphere. The other is what I'm going to do, which is to use redshift. So go back out and in the redshift OBJ tab and in the particles tab, enable render object as particles and adjust the global scale as you need to. Now you can go ahead and start rendering. If you made it this far, congratulations. You've now learned how to create this multi-interaction Vellum simulation. If you thought this was awesome, share this video with your 3D community, and leave a like. See you in the next tutorial. Thanks.